Morning everyone. So welcome to the today's session. This is the B-Car and today we will be talking about the importance of communication and time management in aviation. So first we'll talk about the communication. So looking into these slides, so what you can see, the one first one being can see a person in a pilot uniform and the second is an air traffic controller. So this picture is basically representing the communication between these two. So as you all must be aware about the communication which takes place between an ATC and a pilot. So this may include the navigational route provided by an ATC to the pilot. So what happens if both of them belongs to the different countries and they don't just know their regional languages? So what would happen in that case? So as in the second picture, you can see the people belonging from other communities might have some communication error between them. The one speaking English or the other speaking Spanish, French, any other language. So this may become a communication barrier and can lead to mishappening as well. So in order to eradicate the chances of miscommunication, so international language has been introduced as the English. So English is the mandatory and it has the international language. So persons belonging from other places, so they should know English. So what if while a pilot during its flight, so there could be some problems a pilot should must know. So there should be a regular communication between them. So that is why international language English has been there, so that to make the communication really easy. Now, we will talk in brief about the importance of the communication. So this being the first part, that the example of why the communication is really important. And we will talk about few more points about the importance of the communication. So if I talk about particularly aviation, so aviation communication is a crucial component pertaining to the successful functionality of aircraft movement, both on the ground and in the air. So the increased communication reduces the risk of an accident. As I have told you the recent example about communication between an ATC and the pilot. Now, coming on to the next, the aircraft are constructed in such a way that it makes it very difficult to see beyond what is directly in front of them. So that is why in such case, like when a pilot is flying and the visibility is really low, like pilot can't see outside the cockpit. So he has to refer to the air traffic controller as well as on the some of the computer systems as well. But yeah. To get a perfect routing and directioning, and ATC is there to provide the proper guidance and the navigation. So, as safety is a primary focus in aviation, so communication methods such as like wireless radio are an effective way for aircraft to communicate with the necessary personnel. So you all must know that the radio communication really helps. So through the radio communication, the messages are transferred. So aviation is an international industry. As a result, it involves multiple languages. So however, as deemed by International Civil Aviation Organization, so English is the official language of aviation. So this industry considers that some pilots may not be fluent English speakers, and as a result, the pilots are obligated to participate in an English proficiency test. Because this is a quite familiar example, because people belonging from different countries are not much very much fluent in English as compared to Western countries. So in that case, person or a candidate has to first clear the English proficiency test, then only he or she can enter into this profession. So this is the communication loop between the pilot and the air traffic controller. So have you all ever heard about the communication taking place between an ATC or a pilot? So this is showing that how they transmit the information between them. So first being the ATC, if I give you example that an aircraft pilot is asking for a takeoff, asking for permission. So first, ATC is there to give the clearance that yes, now you can take off. So the first message will be transmitted through the ATC and it will go to the pilot. And once the pilot receives that particular message, so he will read back and it transmit. And that will again go to the controller and he'll then clarify and he'll then acknowledge that communication. So now I have a little video for you all. So that video is about how the communication is there between a pilot and an ATC. So I'm just showing you one video. Okay, so now proceeding with the presentation. So I hope you all are clear with the function, the roles, as well as the importance of the communication in aviation, especially talking about the ATCs. Okay, so now we'll move on to why these communication error can happen. So first, talking about a few communication errors that can happen between a pilot and a air traffic controller. So these could be certainly. Okay, so I hope my screen is visible to you all. Communication errors. So the one reason could be the amount of information. Like there could be some chances when the information is not completely delivered. Like it depends on the how much info is delivered and the how the person who is receiving is reacting. The second reason could be the unclear pronunciation. So this is one of the major errors which could happen because like different people having their different accents can have their own way to pronounce the things, and there could be the misunderstanding between the listener and communicators. Like the person is speaking something else and the listener is understanding the other things. So this could lead to communication error. The third being the misunderstanding, just because of the not clearance of the message delivered. So the more information needing transfer, the more chance of error is there. So unclear pronunciation could happen with non-English speakers. So sometimes lack of self-confidence and motivation affects the expression and communication. So to take this into consideration, so that is why the communication between an ATC as well as between the pilot has kept precise and very short. So if I give you an example, like if a flight is looking for a departure, so an ATC will give a 6 to 7 words message. So it could be like after departure, climb straight ahead, London to DME. So these are a few, like the, they don't speak in the sentences, but yes, they speak quite short and very precisely. So they don't like brief, they don't, because you know, for the communication, they don't have much of the time as well. So speaking and explaining the things could be time consuming. So keeping that in mind, so the messages between that are delivered between an ATC and pilot has kept short and very precise. So misunderstanding can happen with both of the native speakers and the non-native speakers through the communication. So for that, standard aviation language is important to improve the situation. So that is why English has been declared as the language of aviation. And not just for the aviation, but English is the standard language, like it is the international language. So according to the US Department of Transportation's report, error between pilot and an ATC may include, so the first one is a readback or the hearback errors. So the pilot who readbacks the clearance incorrectly and the controller fails to correct the error. So in such case, the risk is accounted for 47% of the error, which is found in this analysis. So the second could be no pilot readback. So a lack of pilot readback contributes to 5% of the errors found in this analysis. So hearback error type H. So the controller fails to notice his or her own errors in the pilot's correct readback or fails to correct the crucial errors. So information in the pilot's statements of intent. So such kind of things are accounted for 18% of the errors which are found in this analysis. So generally miscommunication is caused by mishearing of the pilots for 28%. And the pilot who are not responding, counting as a 20%, and the controller mishearing for the 15%, and 10% that controllers don't respond. So also a professional research shows that 30% of the information will be lost during the miscommunication. So now talking about the International Civil Aviation Organization. So as we have discussed it in the very first session, that it is established, and this organization was there to implement the rule of English as an aviation language in 1951 in order to improve the consistency, accuracy, and effectiveness of pilot between the communication of the pilot as well as an ATC. So what was the goal? The goal was to achieve standards that would eliminate communication error, language, and the comprehension difficulties, all of which have been a major cause of operational airspace incidents. So aviation English is highly specialized language, and sequences used by pilots for air traffic controller and other aviation personnel, and it focuses on a particular pronunciation, vocabulary, grammatical structure, and discourse styles that are used in specific aviation context. So ICAO also established the language proficiency requirement to try to rectify multiple issues like reading accents, the terminology, and the interpretation in the communication. So beginning in the March 2008, ICAO set out the requirement that all pilots flying international routes and the air traffic controllers serving international airports and routes must be a level 4 or above and will be continuously reassessed every 3 years. So the criteria to achieve level 4 are as follows. The first is pronunciation. So a dialect and an accent intelligible to aeronautical community. Then the second being structure, So the relevant grammatical structure and sentence patterns determined by language functions appropriate to the task. Then comes the vocabulary. So vocabulary range and accuracy used sufficiently to communicate effectively. Then is the fluency. So that produces stretches of language at an appropriate tempo. And then the comprehension. So comprehension accurate in common that concrete and work related topics and the accent used is sufficiently intelligible for the international community. Then comes in the interaction, the main part. So responses are immediate, appropriate, and informative. Okay, so as we have been talking about flight delays, so this picture is showing like what could be the possible reasons for the delays. So there could be like bad weather, or like there could be some other reasons as well, like the flight is not getting permission from an ATC due to the very like various other reasons. So there are various possible ways for the flight delays as well. Okay, so as we have been talking about the delays, so this is definitely going to impact the time. So for every minute in which is spent in an organizing, an hour is earned. So time management has a crucial role to play in aviation. So it is really important to make every minute count. So aviation, it is a branch of engineering that is least forgiving of mistakes. So managing time is a really important issue because time is seen as a source of production and consumption. In aviation, delays affect the productivity and cost airlines thousands of dollars every year. So if I talk about, according to the Sheffield School of Aeronautics, on top of flight planning, an average of 20 flights per day, a flight dispatcher can put in at least 10 hours of work at a time. So that's a very long and tiresome day of dispatching flights. So while some countries require overflight or landing permit 72 hours before a flight, so some require 24 hours, therefore flight operations dispatchers need to be aware of time lead mandatories, hence manage their time for every single flight. Okay, so time is really crucial. So whether it is a scheduled trip or a charter flight, a private cargo operation, military or ambulance flight, the mission of any flight operator is time bounded. For planning any of these trips to ensure smooth operation and on-time performance, so the flight operators or the dispatchers race against the time because if time is money in every business, particularly when it comes to the planning and requesting services for a trip from departure to landing to take off for next leg or the scheduled destination. Also, time costs money, especially if I talk about the aviation. So one of the famous quotes of the American physicist and the mathematician Freeman Dyson says that aviation is the branch of engineering that is least forgiving of mistakes. So among the mistakes that are costly and not forgiven in the aviation industry are time wasting and the time mismanagement. So time being one of the most important and scarce resource in any business, and any business operation needs to ensure on-time performance in every aspect of the work. So if this applies to all businesses in general, it is not only very important, but also very crucial in aviation industry. So now talking about OTP in aviation. So OTP basically refers to the on-time performance. So shorthand for on-time performance is a widely accepted method of understanding punctuality for different modes of public transport, not just aviation. It provides a standardized means of comparing how well one service provider operates according to its published schedule compared to another. So in aviation, an airline departure or arrival which is considered to be on time has a departure or arrival that occurs within 15 minutes of scheduled time. The schedule is the basis of airline propositions to its customers. So inevitably, external disruptions such as adverse weather condition, the congestion, incidents, and the industrial action can cause delays for operators. But in general, on-time performance can be influenced by the performance of airlines and the airports. So therefore, it is widely used as a powerful key performance indication for airlines and airports and is also a potential service differentiator for marketing the brand to air travelers. So talking more about that, how can the OTP data can be used? So OTP is a valuable metric for airlines and is an outward demonstration of reliability, which can affect brand loyalty and the ticket sales. So the customer satisfaction is influenced by the customer expectations, and a flight that arrives after the scheduled arrival time can be a stressful experience for passengers. Managing expectation is necessary, and on-time performance data provides an external verification about flight reliability. So passengers can be informed regarding the probability of their flight operating on time. Okay, so here now we can see the effect of, like here, you can see a briefing, so how that it can impact, like mismanagement of the time can impact, has a major impact. So it can impact airports, to the airlines. Also, it's not only the airports and the airlines, but the cargo as well as it impacts the passengers as well. So planning and organizing day-to-day tasks is prompts to the appropriate time management. So the one of the issues which is really difficult to manage in aviation is the time management process. So if I talk about like when the aircraft is in place, the time management is one of the most important elements to make operational process effective. So there can be different internal or the external factors that can really affect the time management. So first one, if I talk about the airport, so the airport related deferrals. So such delays may result in the absence of the parking spots, the runway issues, or the conceivable deferral to airport which have not yet left from the previous airport. So due to these reasons, the airport can be impacted to as off hours, and like if a flight is scheduled at a particular time but it hasn't reached the particular airport, so that can lead to the extended stay. And also the capacity, like because you know if there is any delay in a flight, so definitely that the passengers, like if the flight has it is a 200 people flight, the commercial air flight, so that all of the passengers has to wait at a particular place, and you know due to the extended stay, it can cause to the capacity, it can occupy a large space in an airport. So that could be the major reason. Then talking about the airlines related deferral. So these are directly the delays that are influenced under the airlines only. So this could have any of the reasons like the passengers or the baggage and the cargo or the aircraft ramp handling, technical and the aircraft equipment, or there could be a damage in the aircraft which is undergoing the repair and that might take a few hours. And also there could be some the computer operation failure in the cockpit and a flight operation and other causes. So if an aircraft undergoing this deferral, so it is definitely going to impact the airlines. The one being the diversion, the second being the delays, the third being the crew time expiration, and the fourth being the cancellation. So because, you know, the crew which is serving a particular flight has their own schedule. So if a flight is delayed, then definitely the crew is going to miss that particular flight and they have to serve the other flight. And also, if an airline is delayed, so the passengers must be quite fed up with the services and they can cancel the flight from a particular airline and they can switch to the other airlines. So these few things are here to manage the things and so that to get the customers in their particular place only. Then, so coming on to the next, to the cargo impact. So if I talk about of any flight who has to transport the cargo from one place to another, so what if that particular flight got delayed? So that can definitely impact the cargo. So there could be some possible reason that the cargo which has been loaded has some expiry date. So if the flight is delayed for a few hours, or it could take a more time as well. So in such case, the cargo is not really transported, so it may get expired. Then the second comes is the warehouse capacity, as there is a ton of loads which is transported every day from one place to another. So if there is any delay in a flight, so that is going to occupy the warehouse place, and you know that could the capacity could be increased. Then third being the delivery delays. So if the cargo is transported, quite lately, so it is definitely going to be delivered late. So this is how the delays in a flight can impact the cargo. So coming on to the next, the major part that why all this business is running is to get passengers. So if there are delays in the flight, so how that is going to impact the passengers? So the first reason being the baggage, the main problem, because you know the international commercial flights that each passenger carrying 40 kgs of weight, and you know the baggage is that has already been going to the ramp. So there could be some hassles between the passengers to get their baggage. And then the second comes is accommodation. So if I take an example that a particular flight is delayed for 48 hours and a person not belonging to the local area, so that person has to rely on some of the accommodation resource. So that is going to definitely very problematic for the passenger as well as for the airport to manage the accommodation. Then the third being that if the passenger is looking for an emergency flight but the flight is delayed, so he has to switch for the other resource. So in that case, the passenger has to do the rebooking for the other airlines. And the fourth being the information. So this could be the disasters actually, because you know there are various cases when an airline or when an aircraft is flight is really delayed. In particular cases, if I tell you that, and if an aircraft requires 12 hours of functioning, requires 12 hours of maintenance. So in that case, the authorities of airport can't provide the exact information. Reason being, that this could be the disastrous because, you know, the passengers sometimes get started panicking that how we can wait for these long hours. So in that case, the complete information is not provided directly to the passengers due to some safety issues. So the airport, the people working in the authorities, airport authorities, they have to just guide them like, yeah, the flight is being prepared and the operations are being done. You have to just manage the time and all, something like that. So that is how the information, the not providing the complete information can create some panic between the passengers. So a single delay in a flight can impact the airport, the airlines, the cargo, as well as the passengers. So any aviation industry industry's goal should be to make the system resilient to the disruption and pick up when disruption happens. So beyond essential framework plan and execution, airlines need to create plans when disruptions are insignificant and it is contained for quite a long time of outrageous interruptions. When occasion, for example, like there could be other reasons like terrible weather, or airlines have different ways to protect their system against the delays in cost-effective manner by improving the execution, also by reducing the complexity and creating the buffers. So some moves involves the trade-offs and some can affect the other areas. So careful planning and the consideration as well as the consequences are really essential. Okay, so that was all about our today's presentation. So now I'm going to show you one more video. So that is about that how do the airlines handle the flight if the flight delays. So I'll be showing you that video.